Okay.
Okay, we're going to start today with the extended backward roll and extended forward roll.
Fun.
Because we'd say that because, you know, it's the same day. So, I'm going to sit with my back towards you just so you can understand which shoulder and stuff I'm rolling over. I'm choosing to roll over my right shoulder, but like anything else, we're going to do both sides. I'm going to sit up nice and straight. The shoulder's going to be this way. So palm facing to the ceiling. This hand will help you over by coming over to your face, over to the shoulder you're rolling over. So I'm going to lean back.
Feet down and slide to there. For your forward roll, this is the position you're going to be in. Face to the floor, very, very peculiarly. Hand right by your face, so the way you're looking is towards this hand that's down. You're going to slide your bum up, up, together, and roll.
What do you do then separately by themselves to help with both, for prep for both? I'd start with keeping your hands flat and getting your bum up over your head. To there. For the forward roll, I'd start. Let's go this way. I have to lie slightly sideways to avoid the baby. So I'm here. I'm going to slide my bum up as high as I can get it and back down. I do a couple of them before we try the backwards and forwards, and then do it the way that I've done it, join them together. So do them separately by themselves, backward roll, and then a forward roll, and then backwards to forwards. Okay, spins for today. Start with a corkscrew. Invert grip. The trick with it is to kick forward and then bring it round. Now what I'm looking for it to end in your side. It's very, very important that we get this in the right place, because the next course, it'll be a one-handed and then eventually it'll be no-handed. So we do have to make sure that it ends up right in this side bit. So I'm going to walk around with this in invert, so it's going to be down the way rather than up really tall. I'm going to walk around after I've set up my inside, kick and spin it round. Head back, land into the ground, and like I said, right in the side. Same again the other way. So if I'm this way, step off the inside, kick, and then round. Right the way down to the ground. Next spin for today, ejector spin. I love the ejector spin. It's basically broken down into a half Hollywood, and then you're going to put your hand on the ground and shoot your legs out. Don't take any hands off, like my students love to do. I'm going to step off my outside this time. That's because my inside leg is going to come on. The outside leg will sweep round, come round the front with the inside, so you're in a double closed front hook. Once you get to the ground and your feet touch the ground, hand down under your shoulder and then shoot the legs out. So I'm going to go step, leg on, swoop, bring it right the way around, hand down and slide. And up. So we'll go to the side, step off the outside leg, outside, inside, swoop, down and slide. Very nice. Next one. Finding two legs straight. So, sounds simple enough. If you struggle with your core, you might find it really hard to keep your legs up nice and high. You want nice pointy toes. This is normally our fireman. So be nice and straight. Step. Straight legs. Right the way down to the ground. Same again the other side. Just like in every course, I'm only doing it once either way. You will do it three times either way. Regardless if it's a hold, an invert, whatever the exercise may be. That's the last of the spins. Okay. For the strength training for today, one-handed climb to crucifix. I'm only doing this as one climb. So I'm going to put the leg on with the arm that's up. This leg is going to come around the front, and then I'm going to stand in an upright crucifix. So I'm going to pick it up to there and hold it straight. Nice and slidey today, of course. Same with the other way. Up and then straight. Okay. Hood ornament. Any holds, like I said before in the previous courses, I do from the floor first, just so you can figure out where you're going. If I'm in my climb like this, I'm gonna bring this inside leg round, foot to bum, and this leg will go underneath. This inside arm will come down, traps it just in the armpit, and the outside arm will come off. So I'm gonna bring it up, over to the side, foot to bum, really trapping it behind the knee, armpit, and then hand off. Same the other side, it'll be this way, to there, and then hand off. For the next one, upright figurehead, really, really similar. You're gonna go up from the same position, sneak the leg through, except this time, instead of coming to here, this arm's gonna roll through, onto the shoulder, turn the other hand into cup grip. For those who haven't done a shoulder mount before, this will be very new. Head back, now you'll know if you're in the incorrect position if you're on your spine. You can't get your head back when you know you're in the wrong place. You want to be able to bring the head back to there. So I'm gonna climb up, up, out to the side, foot to bum, other foot behind, sneak it through to there. And down. Same again the other way. To there, sneak it through, head back. Okay. We are finishing with a butterfly. So, like anything, if you haven't already got your mat out by now, definitely get your mat out. Especially if there's no, even if it's not, you could be tired, your grip might not quite be there. Should have put dry hands on yourself, but you know. When we go upside down, this inside arm's gonna come down. Then this leg will be on, the other will come backwards. So I'm gonna go upside down. I'm gonna put this hand down. If you can't kiss the pole, do not take your legs off. This leg will stay on the front, the back leg will come backwards. To there, hold it there.